Well, welcome. Now, in this video, we are going to use NotebookLM to assist in overcoming imposter syndrome in a career or job search. We're going to start with a factual background. So we're going to write down the facts of all of the things that have been accomplished in the course of a career. This is about one typewritten page. We're going to upload this document to NotebookLM. We are going to upload our grounded reality document. And our document is now uploaded. We're now going to use a prompt that we want the AI to use. And it's basically a way for the AI to interpret how it's going to interact in the interactive audio. We're going to be a little corny in number four, and we're going to ask for the AI to stop every 3 minutes and to ask for the user to stop and look at what they've built. Now, if you're doing this for yourself, you're going to want to put your name there. If you're doing this as a coach for someone else, if you want to put the person's name in here, you can. So we're going to put the person's name in there. We're now going to upload those instructions for the audio overview into the sources area. With both sources selected, we're going to click on audio overview. We're going to do a deep dive, and for good measure, what we're going to do is we're going to select long length. We're also going to paste in our instructions again here in this area. Once we do that, we're then going to generate the audio. We are taking advantage of the fact that we can interact with the audio. We're taking advantage of the fact that the source is persistent. So, in other words, we're only using the sources here. And we've taken time to ground NotebookLM by giving it a specific set of facts. What we're looking to do is to generate an audio that can be listened to and/or before every interview. And our audio is complete. Before we go to the interactive portion, we're going to play a little bit of the audio.
Welcome back to the Deep Dive. Today we're doing something a little different. We aren't just reading a career document.
No, not at all.
We are pulling up the legendary performance tape, we're settling into the analyst booth, and we are dissecting the stats of a strategic athlete. Someone who has really defined success in the hyper-competitive small business arena for over a decade.
Exactly. It's like we're breaking down game film. And when you look at the source material we have, you realize this isn't just a list of jobs. This is a highlight reel demonstrating 13 years of consistent high-impact performance.
And the player we're watching today.
We are looking at a veteran, Thomas Duncan.
So what we're now going to do is we're going to go into the interactive portion, and we're going to interact with this audio.
Welcome back to the Deep Dive. Today we're doing something a little different. We aren't just reading a career document, no.
Not at all.
We are pulling up the legendary performance tape, we're settling into the analyst booth, and we are dissecting the stats of a strategic athlete, someone who has really defined success in the hyper-competitive small business arena for over a decade.
Exactly. It's like we're breaking down game film. And when you look at the source material we have, you realize this isn't just a list of jobs. This is a highlight reel demonstrating 13 years of consistent, high-impact performance. Oh, wait, someone wants to join. Hey, go for it.
So how do I, Thomas Duncan, make the point that I have been doing this over a decade without making it sound like my knowledge is stale?
That is a phenomenal question.
And it cuts right to the core of this whole conversation.
Because that fear of sounding stale is what leads to imposter syndrome, right?
You worry that deep experience looks like a lack of modern knowledge.
Here is the key, Thomas. You don't lead with the years.
You lead with the evidence of adaptation within those years.
Your value isn't that you did this for 13
Your
years.
value is that you consistently solved completely different problems over 13 years.
Look at the data points we have.
You moved from community-driven email marketing for a bakery
To hyperlocal SEO for a 12-location hardware chain.
To massive e-commerce pivots during the 2020 crisis.
Oh, yeah, let's hear it.
Should I talk a lot about the bakery or should I keep it vague?
That is the perfect follow-up question, Thomas.
And it relates exactly to the point we were just making about how to frame your history.
Do not keep the bakery story vague. It is your origin story.
You want to use the bakery as the foundational example of your innate skill.
Because it proves your ability to achieve results with zero resources.
The sources confirmed you use nothing but community-driven email marketing and look.
So interaction with an audio that you set up, or that your coaching student sets up, or that the person that you're trying to help sets up, is more than just a resume booster. It is a confidence builder and can be used at any time. So once again, the components are instructions on how to get the audio to interact, a factual document of the of their background so that the AI can provide the narrative, and then interactive audio inside of NotebookLM. In the next video, we'll undertake the same process with a solopreneur or independent online information marketer. Thanks and have a great day.